Hi there and welcome to our SendPulse channel. This time we are going to deal with re-engagement or reactivation campaigns. We will pin down why they are paramount to your email marketing routine and demonstrate how to run a smart series of win-back emails. So, off we go! Let's say you've got emails gathered at conferences, workshops, and of course through sign-up forms on your website. A year has passed since you last contacted those subscribers, and now you're eager to reconnect with them. Well, easy there, as sending emails after such a radio silence may become a real bummer for your email marketing routine, and here is why. First, your subscribers might have forgotten about you and have no idea how they got on your mailing list, or maybe they are no longer interested in the content you want sent. In this case, the unfortunate destination of your emails is a spam folder. Second, your database might contain role accounts and domains with typos. This means your emails will fail to deliver and damage your sender reputation. And third, the user could have simply stopped using the address you have. Reaching these users isn't worth your time, you won't be getting proper statistics, and you will pay extra money for processing inactive emails. To prepare the outdated mailing list for regular campaigns, you've got to come up with a reactivation plan. Let's have a look at how it can be done. First of all, clean your database. At this stage, get rid of invalid addresses and role accounts starting with info@ or sales@. Next, make sure you correct domains with typos and delete repeating addresses. You can do this manually, but in case of a huge mailing list, use email validators. Online tools like Snowv.io and Bright Verify will automatically clean your database. All these tools share the same working principle. You upload the list of addresses, push the Verify button, and get a modified list of contacts. When your mailing list is sparkling clean, you can create a resubscription email. This way, you'll be able to keep it going with engaged subscribers and cut down the numbers of spam complaints. This is what Yes Lifecycle Marketing do in their win-back campaign. The email meets the reader's eye with a hot melting doggy and states, "We promise we are worth your time." The company also provides proofs by offering unlimited access to the company's most popular reports, webinars, and guides. The users can remain subscribed by clicking the CTA or permanently opt out by following the hyperlink. Reactivation is a time-consuming process, and you're unlikely to reconnect with subscribers using a single campaign. This is why I recommend thinking through a series of automated emails. Your first step would be reminding your subscribers about yourself. Address the recipient by name and remind them why or how they signed up. Explain why you've been away for a while, and this will help you to jumpstart your connection efforts. Take a look at a possible email created with SendPulse. The company explains it has been busy improving its website, but now it is coming up with a wider range of services and offers. The user can choose between two options: click the CTA and resubscribe, or scroll past and ignore the request. Next, send an email with a survey. Ask subscribers what topics and products appeal to them. Remember to find out how often they would like to hear from you. Doing so, you'll be able to fill your campaign with relevant and valuable information. Parker, for example, sent a similar re-engagement email and wrote, "We've been missed." They offered their subscribers to choose topics that appealed to them so that the company could improve their future campaigns. And finally, tempt your subscribers with a discount bonus. In case your subscribers didn't find your previous emails engaging enough, offer them free shipping or a checklist with information they might find useful. Sweet Tomatoes, for example, turn to humor while trying to renew communication with inactive subscribers. They caught the reader's eye by writing, "Salad is crime," and then added, "Okay, actually we just watched it." I would give these guys a chance at the top of their perk with a 25% order discount. And don't neglect the unsubscribe link in each campaign. This way, users unwilling to hear from you will be able to opt out with no sweat and won't mark your emails as spam. By the way, there is one more life hack on how to stay away from spam folders. Send your reactivation emails portion-wise. Send your first email to 10% of your database. In case the spam rate after this campaign is below 0.5%, send the same email to another 20% of your mailing list. Stick to this routine until the whole database gets this email. Also remember to monitor clicks and opens during the reactivation campaign. This way, you'll be able to segment the updated mailing list and move all active users to your primary database. And there you are! Did I miss anything? Comment below on how you reintroduce a dusty list of subscribers to your email program, and also suggest other marketing issues you'd like us to highlight in upcoming videos.